Well, good morning. And what a lovely way to start this little piece all about maggot fishing. Now, it's November time. The nights have drawn in. It's getting rapidly colder. And maggots and naturals are a super important part of my armory when it comes to this time of year. So during the course of this little video, I'm going to run you through how I get the best out of them. And hopefully, we'll catch a few carp in the process. Follow me to bus, man. So there we have it. Real brute of a linear. Lovely one, just under 25 pound. The rod's only been out about an hour, so it's a really positive start. Let's get this one back, get that rod out there. And most importantly, start running you through some of them tips to get the best out of your maggot fishing. Happy days. Well, I don't know how well you guys can see, but it really is wet and blustery out there. Been a great start, had that fish nice and early. I only got here first thing this morning, so it's a right result that. Had a little walk round, had a little chat with Josh, and I've plopped myself up in swim four on Wigeon. It's the widest point of the lake. I just think it's a good vantage point to get any passing fish, and I do think the fish are gonna hold up out in front of me. So the weather, as I say, really is quite grim, but it is due to pass in the next hour. So I'm gonna get some breakfast on, hopefully wait for another take, and see out this weather, and then I'm going to run you through some of my tips and tactics to get the best out of your maggot fishing this winter. And make sure you stay tuned to the end of the video. We're going to give you guys the chance to win over £50 of Avid Terminal that I've been using during the course of this session. Right, so when it comes to mix, as I say, it's heavily maggot based. But on venues like this where there's lots of nuisance fish, lots of little carp, perch, things like that, I still want some food value out there. It's November, I'm fully aware the water's getting cooler, but those big carp, they still want some food. So when I mean food, I mean boilies. So got some 8mm bug, which I think are fantastic, particularly as the water's cooling down. They're nice and small and they complement the maggots. They're lovely and soft, so I'm going to crush a few of them up as well. There'll be some dust, some quarters and some holes. This is just enough bait for over one rod, so I'm not going to go crazy. So I've got one big handful of boilie there. Go for one more small handful, crush them up, and that just opens up the bait and helps those liquids get in. Then got my nice maggots there that I've cleaned off. Couple handfuls of that, so it's probably 50-50. Good old faithful krill meal. Now this is buoyant, but when you obviously add some liquids to it, it's going to help it sink down, and the fact it's buoyant means it's going to be working the water column and intercepting any fish that might be spending some time off the bottom. So loads of smell in that, little sprinkling of that, good old liver powder again, really complements the maggots and the boilie, little dusting of that. And lastly, liquid liver. Now this is really thick. It's brilliant to get those powders and that krill meal to the bottom, and it's fantastic in cold water. So we'll have a good old dollop of that in there. It's just a case of getting your hands in, getting dirty, mixing it all up. So now that'll come quite tacky. So it's quite lucky on this session, I'm actually throwing the bait in, but this would be brilliant if you were spotting it, using a bait boat, etc. But it really is quite tacky, so I can almost ball it up and throw it in. And there we have the finished mix. Some nice little boilies, bits of crumb, that krill meal that's going to work the water column, and that liquid liver to really penetrate the lake bed and keep those fish coming back for more. Absolutely fantastic cold water mix, that. comes to fishing with maggots, your presentation is super important. They're, by their nature, they're quite a small bait, and I really think finessing things down really does pay dividends. Now, my first presentation, which is my first port of call, is the D-Rig. Now, it's about 8 inches in length. I've got a small loop on the end. I've quick changed it onto my leader. In this case, I'll fish it on a helicopter. I've got a little tungsten sinker in the middle. I've got a 10-turn knotless knot with a size 4 chod hook. A nice size D there to give the hook bait plenty of movement, and a 10mm highlight with a bunch of maggots. Now, if I'm fishing on a nice clean bottom, whether that be silt or a particular hard spot, this will be my first port of call. It's fantastic when you're fishing over a spotted area, if you're using it with a bait boat, even if you're lowering it in the edge, this would always be my first port of call. Now, next up is the Ronnie rig. Now, it's super in vogue at the moment, and for good reason. And this one's set up with a 40-pound outline boom, so that's lovely and stiff. If I was chucking it to the moon, this would be what I'd be using. Got a little Ronnie swivel on there. I've cut the ring off so it sits nice and low to the lake bed. I've got a D-Rig kicker and a size 4 curve shank, which really does lend itself to this presentation. Hook bait-wise, I've got a 14mm highlight mounted on a micro rig swivel, and again, a nice little bunch of maggots, probably about 16 there. Now, the real beauty of this is, a lot of guys have a lot of confidence in the Ronnie, and I fully expect that if you have a rig that you're confident in, it really does pay to stick to that. So if you want to fish it as a pop-up, it's super versatile. And I love the fact with the Ronnie that if you do want to fish it as a wafter, it's just a case of nibbling down that highlight to make it sit nice and low to the lake bed. And last up, we've got a little solid bag presentation. Now, that's super simple to tie. That's a little slip D kind of presentation. I've got a loop at each end. I've got a little cut down XL liner. Size 4 wide gape, and a little piece of foam mounted on a micro rig swivel. So for me, when you're fishing maggots, you want to make sure you've got a maggot hook bait on. I see lots of guys using wafters and pop-ups, but for me, I just think they get left alone. The carp are in the swim searching out those maggots. Now, when it comes to attaching the hook baits, you'll notice that all of the hook baits that I've got on here are all mounted on a micro rig swivel, and that's for good reason. It's super easy to change your hook baits. I don't want to be threading on maggots onto foam all session. I can recycle those over the rigs, and it means I spend less time faffing around and more time fishing effectively. Now, I do that with a length of floss and a needle. I simply thread them on the needle, mount some floss on the micro rig swivel, thread on the foam, and then thread on my maggots. So there we have my three super neat presentations when it comes to fishing with maggots. Right, so my last and arguably most important tip when it comes to fishing with maggots is all about storage and keeping them nice and fresh. So when I go in the tackle shop, when I get my maggots, I'll order them from a local shop, and then it all depends on the venue, but I'll often take between 1 and 3 gallons depending on how long I'm going for. So what that means is, when I go to the tackle shop, I get them put straight into a 10 litre bucket with plenty of maize on them, and I'll stick the lid on and make that bucket airtight. That will slowly suffocate the maggots down, stop them sweating, and stop them deteriorating over time. It's worth noting, if you're going to put them in a bucket like that, if it's any longer than a couple of days, you want to wake them up in between just to let them get some fresh air and then suffocate them back down. Otherwise, you will struggle with them all coming back to life. Now, when it comes to maggots, when I'm in session, I like to keep them in that airtight bucket. I don't want them getting crazy in the bucket, sweating and smelling. I'll get a couple of pints out, however many I might need, kind of to rebait or to start the session, and I'll put them into a separate bucket. Now, give them a little bit of time in an open top bucket to get plenty of airflow, and they'll come back to life and start wriggling like crazy. Now, when they're like that, they're in that old maize flour. I want to get that off them, and I want to add a few different powders to them to give them a little bit more pulling power. So with the aid of a riddle, nothing too advanced. In this case, I'm probably going to put a couple of pints out just to rebait. So doing a couple of goes, I'll chuck them on the riddle and give them a shake and get all of that old maize meal and bits of sawdust off them and clean them up real nice. Got a separate clean bucket here, and I'll go straight into that. So there's about a pint there, maybe. I'll get a couple more handfuls in here, and I'll give that another nice good shake. Clean these off, like so. Now go in the bucket. Now, like that, they're perfectly fine. But for me, particularly on venues where they see lots of maggots, I just want to give them a little bit more appeal than kind of your average Joe. That little bit of extra effort always seems to pay off in my eyes. So, got a bag of krill powder here. This is great. It's really fishy and adds some real important food value to those maggots, particularly when the water's coloured or the water's deep. I really like that added smell that you don't get with maggots if there's nothing on them. So a little bit of krill meal on them, not too much. and lastly some liver powder. I'm super confident with this stuff. I think it's got great cold water pulling power, and as I say, it really complements the maggots themselves. So probably 10 grams of that on the top, not too crazy with that, and I'll give those a little mix round. And as you can see, lovely clean maggots, but those lovely powders on them, they've got loads of pulling power. It might just set you apart from the other guy next door. Now, it's worth noting with maggots, they are expensive. So if you're left with some at the end of your session, what I'll do is, the suffocated ones that I've got in the bucket, I'll riddle them off nice and clean. I'll put them in some kind of sandwich bags, little zip seal ones, squeeze all the air out and stick them in the freezer. And they're perfectly good like that, just to frost them in good time for your next session. And yeah, dead maggots are just as lethal as live ones. Right, so after that first bite, it's all gone a little bit quiet. But to be honest, that was a little bit of a turn up for the bucks. This time of year, I often find going into dark and through the night's the best time. So to get these rods refreshed, a bit of bait out there, and hopefully we'll have a carp to show you soon. So as I've said, I'm redoing the rods. Just ran the left-hander in, still absolutely needle sharp. Those maggots haven't been touched. So just gonna quickly nick on a little mesh bag. I really like it. You just get a little concentrated pile next to your rig. Got quite a long tag on that mesh bag, as you can see. So I'll hook it at the top, then I'll wrap it around my hook bait on the D and then hook back through the mesh. And what that'll do is it'll fix the hook bait in position, stop the hook point potentially penetrating one of their maggots, impeding the hooking potential. And then it's got a little cap there with some liquid liver in. I know it looks gross, but I really do rate it in the cold water. I'm just gonna rub that on the bag. That's just gonna complement that bit of krill meal and that liver powder on my maggots. Just give it a little bit more pulling power in this colored water. Let's get it out there. Well, as promised at the start of the video, we promised to give you guys the chance to win a bundle of terminal items that I've been using during the course of this session. Now, for your chance to win, make sure you comment below the number of maggots that I said I was stitching on top of my foam when I was talking about some rigs during the course of the video. Good luck. So as I mentioned earlier, at this time of year, there's a real switch and a lot of your action will come at night or in the dark. And it's only been dark about an hour. Redid the rods not long ago. Just had a really slow, steady take on the right-hand rod. Run to another lovely fish. So fingers crossed she stays on. We have a nice big Dog Lane carp to show you. Like that then. A lovely mid upper 20 ghosty common. There's quite a few of them in this lake. They're not to everyone's taste, but to be honest, I really like them. And with Halloween being just last week, it's quite fitting that we have a lovely ghosty for this trip. But yeah, proof in the pudding, those maggots are working, even though it's dark now, obviously. They really do search them out, especially them powders and liquids on. Let's get this back and hopefully we're interrupted by another couple during the course of the night. Happy days. And that's about that then. The third fish of the session. I had this just on first light, so we thought we'd keep her. Give you a little look. Lovely linear. Just proof in the pudding that those maggots, alongside those few other little bits and pieces, making all the difference at this time of the year. A lot of the time in the autumn and the winter, the lakes can be quite tricky. So three bites on a nice short session will do just nicely. Now, as we mentioned at the start of the video, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the Avid YouTube channel, and comment below the answer to the question for your chance to win that little giveaway of Avid goodies. Thanks for watching.